In week 10 for Hockey Tactics, we're going to look at two-on-ones, specifically from the offensive side. And then next week in week 11, we'll look at two-on-ones, defending them from a defenseman's perspective. And the two lessons will kind of go hand in hand as you'll learn what the offensive guys are considering. So then that'll help us next week as we look at defending. So a few things that we want to consider as we go through these clips. We're not going to necessarily look at a whole bunch of different options of plays and stuff like that that you could do on a two-on-one. I just want us to get us thinking about a couple concepts. So the first is seeing what the goalie sees. So the goalie is always lined up with the puck. You could say seeing what the goalie sees, or you could also term this seeing what the puck sees. So it's very, there's a big difference based on which way we shoot. So if I'm coming down the left side and I am a left-handed shooter, the puck's going to be on the outside of the ice, a deader angle for the goaltender. If I'm a right shot coming down the left side of the ice, puck is on the inside, it's a much more dangerous scoring opportunity for the shooter. So understanding that, understanding the difference of how the goalie lines up with the puck. We're going to look at reading defensemen, so if they overplay things where their stick is, how to read that, and then how to manipulate that, which is the fourth point on here, is deception. So how do we make the defenseman move his stick? And then the third option here is the support options. So do we stay high? Do we open up for a one-timer? Do we drive the back post? All kinds of different options. And specifically, the theme of this is going to be on which way we shoot. And something that not a lot of us consider, we look at two-on-ones and it's get the puck across the defenseman or shoot for a rebound. But let's consider in these clips which way the players shoot. And we'll look at four different scenarios of possibilities. So the first one is the most dangerous play, most dangerous scenario, two players with their sticks on the inside. So when we say off wings here, that means that you're coming and your stick is towards the inside of the ice. If we say strong side, that means your stick is on the outside. So here, this is a threat because this player now, if I draw a line from the puck to the middle of the net, okay, there's a lot of, that's a good angle. There's a lot of shot opportunities. If this player here was to shoot left, his stick would be out here, the puck. That's a big difference between those two lines that I just drew in terms of angle and opportunity to score. So the right shot here having the puck in the inside of the ice, he has to be respected by the goalie. That's a dangerous shot that he could score from there. And then there's also this one-timer. We talked, as a reminder here, a lot lately about this Royal Road and passes across. So that's a very dangerous play if that puck can get across the defenseman for that one-timer. So we're going to look at just an example here. This is one that we saw in our one-timer clip, but as a reminder, so here's the player, dangerous shooter, Ovechkin, as a right shot. He moves that puck laterally, no chance for the goalie on the one-timer there. But watch right here, we talked about this the other week. He's a threat to shoot the puck, and that's what makes this so dangerous. He's a threat to shoot the puck, but he knows by faking, I'm going to move that defenseman's stick. That's the deception and manipulation. And get the puck across to my buddy for a one-timer. Second scenario is the puck carrier's got the puck on the outside. So if it's from the left side, left-handed shooter, the angle's not as good as what we saw in the first one where the puck was somewhere around here. The angle's on the outside. So not as dangerous and great of an opportunity to score off a shot. But you've got a dangerous option here with a one-timer guy. All right? The other thing that makes this difficult, the other thing that a lot of players will do, which is a mistake, is this player will try to drive the net on his backhand or even awkwardly opened up. That's a tough play. And so if possible, you're better off to kind of hang a little bit higher and be open as a one-timer threat on this type of a two-on-one. So we're going to watch one. This is where it's not done very well. So the puck carries on the outside. He doesn't have a great chance to score from out there. And just keep your eye on this player here, and I'll let it run. So the puck comes across, he gets a whack at it, but doesn't get a great handle on the puck. And all this player needs to do is take a stride and open up his toes facing this way with his stick on the inside here. Now that becomes a very dangerous one-timer play. Even if he walks around here and makes a pass, if this player's toes were opened up and he can one-time that puck, much better chance of getting it in the dangerous scoring area. Next scenario, probably the least dangerous, is two players with their sticks on the outside. So again, the shooter doesn't have a great angle. Now this player can't really open up for a one-timer, and his stick is also ahead of him, so it's easier for the defenseman to have his stick here and take away that lane. So most times, if you're in this situation, this guy, you're better off to drive to the net with your stick out in front of you. And then you can one-touch a pass that comes to your forehand. So we'll look at a scenario here. First one ends up with a great save, so it's a terrific scoring chance. And so I want to watch here. The player waits when that stick moves right there. That's the deception. Now he moves it across to a player. Shot and a terrific save. Watch again. Watch this defenseman's stick and when the pass happens. So right there, just in front of it. And he's just a little bit slow getting the puck off, but a terrific save. Now you could argue that there'd be a better option for this player. If we back it up, if this player here were to drive the net a little bit deeper and get a play through here, he doesn't have to catch and release. He can almost one-touch that puck and give himself a better chance to score. So we're going to look at another scenario. Exact same, both players have the sticks on the outside. But this player is going to continue to drive the net. So he drives the net, stick on the ice. He doesn't need to really shoot. He just deflects it into the open net. Another example here. Also important to note, this looks like a 2-on-2. But this is pure will. This player wins the race up the ice. So right now he's created a 2-on-1. He's going to keep his feet moving to the back post. And a shot right there. So a terrific play. Driving the back post. The last scenario is a combination here. So now we've got the puck on the inside, similar to the first example, a great scoring chance for the shooter, but he doesn't have the one-timer option. He's got another player also on his strong side here, so this player could continue to drive the net, maybe take the D back with him, and this player can shoot, or we've got that option if the defenseman overplays the shooter, to hit a guy driving the net through there. And we'll look at that in this example. McDavid, pretty good player. So he's got the puck on the inside, and this defenseman overplays it. So we talk about reading the defenseman. He overplays this puck, so McDavid knows he's got a guy driving the net. He's going to make that pass. And he doesn't waste any time, doesn't overstick handle. He gets the puck on his stick, off his stick. So the reason for showing those is I want you to consider when you get in a two-on-one situation, where do I have the puck? Is it on the outside or the inside? And if I'm the support guy, am I in a one-timer option? Or should I be maybe driving the net with my stick on the ice on my forehand side?